Hi, so I'm Ankur. I'm one of the founding principals at Studio Lotus.
Hi, I'm Pankhuri. I'm a principal at Studio Lotus. Our team at Studio Lotus is, we're around 50 people strong, and we're a multidisciplinary organization. So really what the clients came to us with was, they had this whole idea of placemaking, because Godrej has such a rich history and legacy, and these, like, the buildings that they had at site were one of the oldest factories from Godrej. So they wanted to retain those buildings and create stories around them. So how do you create a sense of place for Godrej? Because one of, like, their most important building, which was Godrej One, which is their headquarters, was coming up at the same site. So how do you create a unique identity for the site was really the brief that was given to us.
So it's a 30-acre total, approximately 30-acre land, which is being developed and repurposed for residential buildings. It's a mixed-use space. And primarily, basically, the connection is to the Eastern Highway. That's a connect to the site from the Eastern Highway. The site overlooks the massive mangroves, I think the last mangroves of Bombay. And the idea was to create a principal access guiding all the lines of sight to the mangroves. And what we started with, I mean, of course we had a master plan, but what we started with was two cogen buildings which became
two
like
old industrial buildings, yeah, at site,
which became like a gateway to the property. And so the residential towers and
the commercial
hub here, and the Godrej headquarter building, Godrej One, was right next to the space that we started our work in. So we actually worked on an area approximately about an acre.
So the idea was that the buildings which we were going to touch would stay as a part of the overall development, but the function would change. So if it's a marketing office now, later it could be attached to the hotel, it could become the nightclub for the hotel, so that purpose would also evolve as we go along.
So I'll start with the entrance experience that I was talking about. So the, principally what we had was a drop-off that directly kind of connected you to the two main buildings and the first plaza that you would walk through. And we had a really tall old chimney tower that we kind of used as a beacon, which would be
like a marker.
It's a marker, and it's highly visible from the main road, from the expressway. We used the old structure that was housing the boiler and converted it. So we used the old frame and we converted the building into the cafe that kind of anchors both the plazas. So we had a front plaza, we had a rear plaza, which kind of opened up into an amphitheater. And then we created a little park that would allow for some benches, and it's a little area for spill out for kids. And we also ended up using a lot of old silos from the site, and we repurposed them to showcase the legacy. So it tells the story of Godrej and what Godrej stands for. There was a small urban garden that was cultivated at one point on the site. The two main buildings were purposed for the marketing journey, which primarily conveyed what Godrej's philosophy was for all the buildings, and they would walk you around the site and kind of have a conversation about what they were up to. And there were sample apartments which were housed in the workshop space. The workshop space was also geared up to do large events, and this plaza outside would become the seamless connect. And you know, like, this is where they used to have larger gatherings and run larger events, which kind of connects to the larger site and
the overall
development. And in a way, if I was to just connect back to, these would be the axis of connection later when the development kind of grows. So there's already a connection to Godrej One, which is already at site. the people who are in the office space have already started using this space. So in the afternoons and evenings, you can see people hanging out in the plaza and walking up. So social is probably coming up and taking up the space, and they're going to run it.
So another interesting device which we added to this was just a storytelling element. So what we inserted was a strip which sort of runs through the site, and it takes you through all the elements in the site. So it takes you to the studio, from the studio you turn around and you go into the workshop, then it leads you to the boiler cafe, it takes you to the marketplace. So it's actually like a physical strip which runs in the ground, and it takes you through the entire site.
So we had a very distinct form of, you know, the existing warehouse buildings, and what we ended up doing was we just re-articulated the buildings in a new material language that we thought was would give meaning to these buildings. So we worked with cotton steel, and we retained the existing framework of the building and rendered it in concrete. So the idea was to create a sense of timelessness, and so we kind of took the existing elements. So the roof was re-articulated in a industrially crafted kind of metal sheet work. And what the louvers did, what we did to the louvers was we actually changed the scale of them. We added a detail of perforation in it, which would bring in dappled daylight through the day, and it would kind of change the environment inside the building. Parts of the building were created to seamlessly open up to the plaza. So at the lower edge, there were large sliding folding, large pivoting doors, which would open up and connect the building back to the plaza. And within the building, what we did was, we actually wanted to break away from this rigidity or kind of straight line character that the building had. So we inserted a fairly kind of fluid form, and we played with a old silo, which became like a cyclorama, like a projection system, which would convey the story of the development. And we put a spiral staircase that would wrap around the old silo, and that would take you up to the mezzanine level. So we actually, because we had a massive height, we kind of ended up using double floor plates and creating discussion areas at the upper level. And at the lower level, there were some office spaces, back of house spaces, and the front end was where we had actually displayed a very large model of the site. In terms of the insert itself, we worked with a very simple idea of, so the form was articulated in timber slats, because the entire building had an industrial character, so we wanted something really warm in there. So,
and also the form was also derived from the forms that we found at site. So yeah, you know, this whole idea of the silos, which was such a strong feature at site, we said that while we were using the silos in the landscape, how could we bring the story of the silos in the interiors as well? So that's how the circular forms came into being. So while it helped soften the interiors of the building, the story came from the silos that we found at site.
You know, in terms of the articulation of the facade itself, we ended up kind of working with a very simple mullion system, which was an inspiration from, again, say the construction techniques of the early modernist kind of times, and it allowed a lot of transparency into the building. So it became like a large lantern in the evenings, and you could see this ghost-like structure with the slatted timber inside. So the amorphous form would stand out in the evenings. That was the idea of this particular building.
So the boiler cafe was another old structure that we found at site. So it was a really simple framework. There was really nothing to the structure. It was just a two-leveled structure that we found at site. Just basic ISMB construction, nothing fancy. What was really interesting about the boiler cafe was that, why it's called the boiler cafe, was that there was this beautiful boiler sitting on top of the structure. So really the idea was to start using this as a hub for the development. So what we started out by doing was to create like an external staircase which connected the two levels. And the same mullion grid that we had developed for the cogen buildings. So the idea was to give this whole site one identity. The boiler as well as the cogen buildings, they all light up beautifully at night. So they all become like these beacons sitting at site. So it's a completely transparent building, even in plan, it's just glass all around. So if this is the plan of the building, so there's glazing all around. And on the ground level, we have these sliding folding doors. So, you know, it all opens up to the plaza. So it becomes like a seamless experience, and the inside and outside spaces become one.
I think one of the things that we really pursued was if you could take people up to the terrace, because the terrace level is really beautiful and you get very nice lines of sight all across. On one side is the mangroves and on the other side would be the development that's coming up.
I think one of our biggest takeaways would be, you know, this whole idea of learning from the past and bringing it to the present, because the history was so important to this site, that how do you take the past and bring it to the present and making it relevant, you know, not making it thematic and cliched. So I think that was the most exciting learning for us from this project.